Hi, I'm Jack Erickson, and I'm here with Sri Srikanthan, and he's going to show us the power of oneAPI software optimizations. Sri, what are you showing?
This shows Stable Diffusion text-to-image generation. This model is made up of multiple modalities, a text encoder to handle the prompt, a unit to perform the diffusion steps, which is the bulk of the processing, then an image decoder to generate the output. So it is a large and computationally intensive workload. This runs on a fourth generation Intel Xeon processor with oneAPI optimizations.
Wow, and it just finished in a few seconds. I thought models like this took like 10 minutes on a CPU to generate an image. How is this so fast?
It is a combination of the hardware and software. The fourth generation Intel Xeon has AMX built-in, which is an accelerator that provides the performance for deep learning workloads. And the software stack gets the most out of these hardware features and instruction sets. Intel contributes optimizations to open source AI frameworks like PyTorch and TensorFlow. And the latest optimizations and features that have not yet been upstreamed are available as extensions for you to be downloaded. Here we are using Intel extension for TensorFlow. All these extensions are open source and free.
All right, so then what is an example of a feature that is unique to one of these extensions that is not yet supported in one of the stock frameworks?
oneAPI is the building block of these extensions, which not only provides optimizations, but facilitates heterogeneous computing. For instance, support for Intel Flex series GPUs is currently available only in these extensions. Here, we can just switch over and run inference on Flex series GPU.
And wow, that was even faster. So what code changes were required to run on the GPU?
No code changes. TensorFlow has a pluggable device mechanism that the extension uses to seamlessly support GPUs.
And that's it? So is this because of oneAPI?
Yes. oneAPI libraries are common across these frameworks and extensions, which allows us to seamlessly transition workloads across hardware. For instance, you can also run PyTorch Stable Diffusion on Intel GPUs with Intel extension for PyTorch. That would take a couple lines of code change.
Okay, so then really it just comes down to what hardware you have available, what frameworks you use, what your needs are. So how would someone try this themselves?
This example ships with Intel extension for TensorFlow. So if you download the extension, you will find this example.
Great. Thank you, Sri. We will be sure to share the link in the description. If you are interested in learning more, check that out. And again, thank you, Sri, for the demo.